Yo! What's up? I am Marthe from Gal in a Cube. I just received this video from Patrick and he's asking for my help. So let's check out what he's asking.
Yo, what's up, Marthe? I've created this entire medallion architecture. Let me show you. In my workspace, in my YouTube metrics workspace, I have my task flow. Let's say I've created this lake house, and you see this lake house, it contains some great information. And if we head over to my data visualization item, you can see I've also created this semantic model. Now in this semantic model, I have some DACs that I wrote, and I don't want anybody to try to reproduce that logic because it's some critical business logic, and I don't want a bunch of variations of that business logic out. This is the source of the truth. And I also need to know who's using my lakehouse or who's not using it. And I need to make all these data products. Can you help me?
Don't you worry, Patrick. I can help. We're going to figure this out together. So Patrick has created and pulled down some data from our YouTube channel. He's created a medallion architecture with a lakehouse and some goal data at the end there. He has a semantic model and a Power BI report. And he wants to manage and maintain that. So this is definitely a data product challenge. And it sounds like something we could fix using Purview. Okay, I'm going to help you out. So Patrick, you will probably be the data product owner of these data products because obviously you're the one that created them, but I could be your data steward, so I'm gonna help you this time, only this time. So let me put on my data steward hat. And you know how I like to do it? Enough of all this talking, let's head over to my laptop. So inside of Purview today, we need to look at governance domains and we need to look at data products. And we do that inside the unified catalog. So let's open up that solution. We go into catalog management and then governance domains. And you see here, I've already created one governance domain called administration. So that's where we put all the data product that's related to administration of GynaCube. We have a product, we have some glossary terms and so on, but I think this should be a new governance domain. So let's start with creating that one. So this is gonna be about YouTube data. So let's give it a name that makes sense. A good description could be this domain contains data products and business glossaries related to GynaCube YouTube channel. Now we could also select a type for the governance domain. Now GynaCube is obviously not your normal organization. So you would probably create a domain called finance or operations or marketing or sales and so on. And it could be a functional unit, but in GynaCube, we're gonna be really pragmatic inside of our Purview solution. So I think this is gonna be a data domain. So we're gonna put all the data about the YouTube channel in here. And you could have also selected the parent, but this is going to be the main domain for this. I'm going to click create. And now we're ready to actually create the data products. So open up data products, click new data product. Now, as Patrick has already showed us in the video, he created a lakehouse containing some gold data. This sounds like a perfect data product to me. So let's give this a name. It sounded to me like Patrick wanted the whole lakehouse to be the actual data product. And this lakehouse contains different types of information and key matrices and views and watch time, subscriber growth, so on. So I'm going to pull in a good description for that. I'm going to say that these are data sets. The audience for this would probably be data engineers or BI engineers, you know, people that are technical that want to actually take advantage of this product. I will put Patrick as the owner, but just because I think he might need some help in the beginning, I will put myself as well. And then the use case for this would be to create semantic models and reports that support content strategy, performance tracking, and audience analysis. Okay, cool. Now, we could have marked this as endorsed, but I think Patrick should be the one to endorse this because I'm just a data steward today. So I'm going to click create. Now we have some options. We could add data assets or set up data access policy. Now let's add some actual physical assets to this. Now, in previous video, we actually scanned the entire Fabric tenant, meaning that all those beautiful assets that exist inside of Fabric are now available to me to pull into data product. So let's see if we can find the lakehouse that Patrick has created. So inside of Fabric, you see here YouTube lakehouse. This is the lakehouse that Patrick showed us. It got some gold data here that we maybe want to package as data products, and also some silver tables as well. And the lakehouse itself also contains the bronze data. If we search for that lakehouse, you see that we could have actually added the default Power BI dataset or the SQL Analytics endpoint if that was what we wanted to add instead. So maybe for you, it makes sense to add the SQL Analytical endpoint as the physical data asset to this data product because that's what you want people to use it for. So here, I think we should actually instead add some of the gold tables of the actual lakehouse and package that as the data product. If I go back to Fabric, you see here we have some fact channel stats, fact daily channel stats, fact daily video stats, fact video stats, and so on. Let's add this one to Purview as a physical data asset. So I'm going to search for that one. And you see here that I'm getting the lakehouse table. This is the actual lakehouse table. So I'm going to choose that and then click add. Now I could have also added all the dimension tables or all the other fact tables as well. This is completely up to Patrick, but I'm going to start here because I think this is one of the main fact tables that we want people to reuse. Now on the right hand side here, you see we can add some more information. Terms of use, for instance, we could say that this gold fact video stats data set got some terms of use. We'll give that terms of use a friendly name. And I think this data is confidential and should not be shared outside of GynoCube. And then you can paste a hyperlink to that terms of use, which could be a SharePoint link. Create. Now we could also add some documentation. Now this could be also a link to GitHub or again SharePoint, depending on what you're using to document your solutions. Now I'm not sure Patrick really did that much documentation, so I'm not gonna add anything now. And then the last thing we also have to do is to manage policies. So if I open up here, you see that we can set up specific policies. Now you could say that, for instance, people that want to use this data need to give a purpose for using the data. It could be that they're assessing the fit, critical reporting, directional insights, or you can add a purpose of your own. We can also set a maximum time allowed for the data access. So in GynoCube, I think we have 1 year as default. We could also say that we need a manager approval, or you also have to have some privacy and compliance review before giving access. The access request approvers would be Patrick, but I need to run this by him before. So I'm going to put myself as the data steward. And then you could also have data access providers as well. So who will be the person that physically grants access to that data? That could be me as the data steward again, or it could be Patrick as well, or someone entirely else. You can decide to permit data copies or not, and add attestation if you have anything else. I think I'm pretty happy with this policy, so I'm gonna save the changes. Cool. And we have now created our first data product. Now that was the lakehouse. Now we also have the semantic model and the report. So let's create a product for that as well. Let's go back to data products. And then we want to create a new one. Patrick also had a semantic model he wanted us to manage and create a data product for. Now you could also decide to combine both the semantic model and the report as one data product. But here Patrick was specific. He wanted to have separate ones. We'll give that a good description. Now this is actually going to be a semantic model. The audience for this semantic model will probably be a BI engineer, business user, or business analyst, or data analyst. I will be the owner together with Patrick. The governance domain will be the GynoCube YouTube channel that we just created. And then I'm going to click create here. Now let's add some data assets to this one as well. Now inside of Fabric, we see here that the metrics analytics was the semantic model that Patrick wanted to manage. Here we see that we have the Power BI dataset. So I'm going to choose that one and decide to add it. Automatically 9 data assets were added, not only the semantic model. And that's because it also added all the delta tables that you have inside of the semantic model. Now, as we did before, we could add some terms of use and documentation. And let's also add some policies. We're just gonna speed this up really quickly because we've already seen this. Now let's create the last data product. That was the actual report. So again, let's go to data products, new data product. We're gonna give it a name. And this is gonna be an actual dashboard or a report. The audience will be data analysts and business analysts, business users, and web executives. We'll put it in the GynoCube YouTube channel governance domain and also provide a use case. Now let's add the report that Patrick mentioned. So that was this report here, video search and stats. I'm gonna speed up and add documentation in terms of use and also the policies. And now the last thing we have to do is to go into the governance domain, and we want to publish this domain as a whole. That means that consumers of the catalog are gonna be able to view it and find it. And the same with the actual data products. Let's publish all 3. Data products are created. Now let's say that we have someone that really wants to consume, for instance, the report. Let's say that Justin Case really wants to consume the report. So now if Justin goes into the unified catalog, go to discovery and data products, you see here that he can see the different governance domain that he has access to. Here you see the GynoCube YouTube channel domain. So if I open that one up, you see all the different data product that we have created. Now Justin, he really wants access to the report itself to consume that. So we're going to go in here, and now Justin can actually click request access. So let's do that. Now this form is going to appear, and the content of the form is going to depend on the policies that we set when we were creating the data product. Justin, he's actually going to do some critical reporting. So the business justification is going to be provide key KPIs to Adam, maybe. And also for terms of use, he's checking off that he understands and acknowledges that data copies are not permitted. That's cool. So when Justin now clicks send, the cool thing now is, because I am the data access provider here, if I open up my email, you see here that I've gotten an email asking, do you want to approve or decline the data product access request for organic attribute metric support? Now I can decide to approve or decline the request, or I can also view all requests and approvals in Microsoft Purview. Now this link is going to send me back to Purview, where I could actually, if I go into catalog management, click at requests here, I can look at all the requests that's been given to me for the different domains that I manage. So organic YouTube channel domain, I open this one up and then I can see, Justin has requested access. And the status is that it's pending. If I open this one up, I can then say that I'm going to approve this access. I'm going to confirm that. The next step will be for the actual data access provider to go physically into Fabric, for instance, and provide access to, in this case, the Power BI app where this report exists. Now, let's say that I've done that. I can say that now it's provided. I have actually given Justin access to the video search and stats, and I could also give some comments or instructions if that is necessary. And when I'm happy, I can complete that request. Now we see that the status is completed and Justin is now officially a consumer of the GynaCube YouTube metrics report. Now we created three quite cool data products for you, where you can monitor the access requests and provide access or not provide access as you see fit. You can also better provide descriptions and definitions of all the business logic that you have put into your semantic model and so on, all those DAX measures that you mentioned, and make sure that it's just one source of truth for me and Adam and everyone to take advantage of and reuse, so that we don't duplicate and replicate all the beautiful things that you have already done. Now, in general, I want to know what you think. Did you like that? Does it make sense? What should be the next things we should dive into for data products? Remember to subscribe to GynaCube to check out all the amazing videos from Adam, Patrick, and myself. And we will see you guys in the next video. Bye.